Okay, Singapore's got some really good options I wanted to talk about. There are some advantages and there are some disadvantages. It isn't a very expensive place, but you can. There are a lot of people that actually live in Malaysia right across the bridge in a place called Johor Bahru. And man, I'm going to tell you something, the prices drop off dramatically when you cross that bridge and you go from Singapore to Malaysia. I'm talking about hotels. Everything drops dramatically. It's amazing. I've never seen two places so close to each other that drop in price so much. I mean, it's a bigger difference than Mexico and the U.S. Crossing the Mexican border to the U.S., I mean, it's a lot of difference in the cost. They both have territorial tax systems, but there are people that do like Singapore better. It is cleaner. It's more upkept. It's a more professional place, but you know, you're going to pay a lot for it. I mean, this is something you got to think about. But they do have some really good options there. They used to have a program where you had to pay, if you wanted permanent residency, you just pay roughly 20 million Sing dollars, and you didn't have to work or anything. If you know, you could show proof of that. You put it in a bank, and you'd get permanent residency, and then you could apply for citizenship after 2 years. Now, they've got a program now that's actually quite a bit less. But, you know, it gets you permanent residency and leads up to citizenship. But I must warn you here that there are some big disadvantages of this program. And I'll give you some comparisons with St. Kitts so you can kind of get an idea between the two, because they are two real small countries. In fact, if you take Nevis and St. Kitts, you put them together and then multiply it times 2.5 times, and you're going to get the same size as Singapore. So that kind of gives you an idea of the difference. Singapore is very congested. It's not like St. Kitts and Nevis is not congested. Your tax laws in St. Kitts and Nevis are a lot better, because there's no income tax, no capital gains tax, no estate tax, no inheritance tax in St. Kitts and Nevis, and almost no property tax at 0.20% of whatever you're purchasing, with a $29,600 exclusion before that 0.20% kicks in. Singapore does have a territorial tax system, which means they don't tax income outside the country, even if you bring it in. But the inside taxes is not as bad as the U.S., but it's higher than what I would want to pay. Let's put it that way. And you have to remember too, everything's going to be higher there, so you're going to be doling out a lot more money. I mean, just a little dinky apartment there is very expensive. It's one of the most expensive places in the world to live. So, but you can do this. Like I said, you can cross the border. It costs about 20 US bucks going back and forth. To me, it would not be worth the time to do that from Malaysia to Singapore. But you can do that. I think it's around 20 bucks round trip ticket the last time I checked, taking your car. And if you take a bus, but I'm going to tell you something, it's the lines really line up, and it's probably not worth it. It is cheap to do it that way, but it's going to take you longer to cross. And, you know, that's the problem there. There's a lot better choices I would pick, but I did want to go over this because there is some really good things about this program. But, you know, Singapore, like I said, it's a nice place. It's a very tropical type of climate. But they've got this program, it's called the Global Investor Program, and it grants citizenship. You get residency for 5 years, and in exchange, you invest 2.5 million Singapore dollars into a new business entity or expand in an existing business. The second option is creating a business plan and putting in at least 2.5 million in an approved fund that investors in Singapore based companies. And you can upgrade this to citizenship, and it's possible after 2 years after applying. But there are some drawbacks, and you know, it's dual citizenship's not allowed there. That's one problem. And I'll tell you something, any country that doesn't allow dual citizenship, myself, I would stay away from it. It does have probably the best passport along with Japan in the world as far as visa-free travel goes. But I'm going to tell you something, as far as that goes, that's about it, because I'd rather have less visa-free travel countries you can go to, but allow dual citizenship and have no income tax inside the country. That I'm going to tell you something, across the board, that's a lot better. Plus, St. Kitts doesn't have a military requirement for you or your kids, and you can get the passport as quick as 45 days. Singapore is going to be a guessing game, okay? Because even after 2 years, I'm going to tell you, I don't know anybody's ever gotten the passport after 2 years applying. And if your net worth's not at least 5 to 10 million, and you're going for the citizenship option, just forget it. There's people getting turned out left and right there. They've got so many millionaires per capita there, and they really don't need people that come in with $1 or $2 million. So if you're coming in with that, first of all, it's going to be very difficult to get a property with that anyway, that has any substantial square footage, okay? So they want people that have a ton of money that's coming in there. And if you don't have that, just forget Singapore. But the military requirements not only pertain to you and your kids, if you're 40 or under, but if you're a permanent residency, in some cases, they can apply to you also. So this is something that you really have to think about, because that's taking a big chance if you're... And of course, Singapore is pretty good about not getting into all these conflicts where you're having, you know, battles, where you're hand-to-hand combat. It's basically going there, serving your time, and getting out. But, you know, do you have the time to do that? That's the thing to do that. You know, in U.S., obviously, if you join the military, you got a lot bigger chance of getting shot and killed, because, U.S. is in battles all the time. You know, U.S. doesn't go out more than 20 years where they get in some conflict or battle with somebody. But again, I would not even apply there. The rejection rate is high. Unless your net worth is high, and you can still get rejected even if your net worth is high. They don't have any sort of stipulation on your net worth being X amount, and then you get the passport. You're just taking, it's like a shot in the dark, man, okay? And one thing I like about St. Kitts is you can get it in 45 days, no income tax, no capital gains tax, no estate tax, no inheritance tax. To me, that's a lot better, you know, type of plan to be looking at. And, it's just, to me, the weather's a lot better, too. Singapore's a lot hotter than St. Kitts. It is a good place if you're going to be looking, if you can overlook those negatives, then that's something that you might want to look at. Anyway, folks, if you want to legally get your income taxes to zero, how to get a second passport as quick as 45 days, 2-3 things, hit the subscribe button on the right of your screen. You get new videos automatically as they come out. And number 2 is, I would like to hear from you. If you got a question or comment, put it below. And number 3 is, go to our website, www.citizenshipquickly.com, and just ask for some help. And I look forward to talking to you on the next video. Take care.